always advise, just plan ahead for the things you know you need to do. And by doing that for my dog's annual vet visit, it actually provided extra cash for me to finally pick up that Fear of God Essentials hoodie. In the back you see shining bright in all of its 3M glory. Very excited to have it. Let's dive right in. TJ back with another video, Talks with TJ, aka TJ Two Swoosh Chains. I know that I've forgotten to say this, but I appreciate all of you Two Swoosh crew tuning into this video. If you're brand new, have no idea what brought you here, would recommend the video. If you just did a random Google search, hey, welcome, what's going on? You can go ahead and subscribe if you like what you see. I never badger you all to hit the like button, but it does help creators. So feel free to hit the like button if you like this video and any others that you happen to see. Today we are discussing how I planned ahead for my dog's vet visit and it allowed me to pick up that hoodie. So, well, I don't know if it's long story short or short story short, but I always advocate having a sinking fund for those annual expenses you know will always come up. I know they tend to creep up on us, but that's really just poor planning. It's not creeping up on us, it's us failing to plan ahead. So I know that every single year, no matter what, my dog needs to go to the vet. That means a series of tests to make sure she is well and healthy, just like any of us would do when we go to a doctor. And I also need to make sure I pay for heartworm preventative medication. Listen, it adds up. Having a dog or having a pet, it is not an easy job because financially you need to provide for them the care, the food, toys, grooming, all of that. You need to make sure you provide that. So I know annually about what it should cost. Now I plan for a little bit more because you never know. I have a senior dog at this point. She's a little bit older, she's 8. So that means additional tests could be needed. So I put aside $440 for my dog's vet visit. She had this visit end of April, I believe. Yeah, end of April. $440 I set aside. Now, how did I easily set this aside? Because you guys see me consistently buying shoes, buying clothes. I'm paying all of my student loans, making sure that I'm saving. I invest in my 401k. That's just automatic, so I never even see that money. But how is it that I just easily did that? And for some of you, yeah, you could just go ahead and pay that. But I think an easy way to do this within your own budget for anything that you could need to do annually is have a sinking fund. So every single month in my budget, there's a line item for my dog that's separate from her food. It's just a line item for my dog and it actually goes towards her vet visit. So I know what the amount, so I budget, you know, 440. So just take 440, divide that by 12, and there you go. Now, the awesome part, when I took her to the vet, it actually didn't cost as much as I thought it would, but I was still in a really good place because if it did cost more, I was prepared to pay that. So with everything going on, they actually come to the vehicle, they take your dog in, they do her checkup, and they give you a call, let you know what the cost will be. You pay pretty much like via your debit or credit card over the phone, and then they drop her back off to my vehicle. So very easily, seamless, and safe process with everything going on, keeping everybody safe and at a distance. And it actually came out to $337. So that left me with additional money to treat myself. Now I could have done other things with it, but for me, if something doesn't cost as much as what I thought it would cost, that's a great opportunity to put that money towards something you've had on your list. And we all have these lists, right? If you don't have a list, get you a list, okay? I have a list of things that I really, really want, and I put off on buying them from time to time because other things could come up. Usually, if it's an immediate sneaker release that's coming up, listen, I go back and shop for Fear of God Essentials. Now, I'm a big fan of Jerry Lorenzo. You guys should know this if you follow me on Instagram. I literally did a side-by-side picture of both of us, and I was very inspired by his style for one of the pictures I took in a video that I did in the park. If you guys have seen that somewhere on my channel, appreciate you for watching. I did a side-by-side, very inspired. I love Jerry's style. I love the fact that it's just elevated classic sweats. Now, for some people that may say, I don't see the value in the fact that you would pay $99 for a hoodie or for some sweatpants, but people do that for Nike and for Jordan and for Adidas or for Yeezy. So why would it be so far-fetched to do that for another brand that you like? Now, I don't own any of the Fear of God, the traditional lines of his. That's a little steep for me. I don't even know if I'd pick that once I am in a position where I'd feel more comfortable with it. But when it comes to the essentials, I'm all for it. Now, I'm still strategic on how I pick up the essentials because as of right now, I only have two pieces. I have the shirt, the long sleeve shirt in the back there in the cream or the white. And then I have the brand new hoodie that I picked up in gray. And then you guys know that I have the Fear of God Air Aid in light bone and black. They are there on the garment rack as well. I only have a few pieces. I'm strategic about it. Both of those items, so the shirt I paid just retail for since restocked the holiday collection, so I was able to pick up the shirt. And then for the hoodie, I picked up on eBay. Now you need to plan ahead. You need to make sure that you're diligent. If you're going to buy off eBay, first off, make sure that you filter to only USA, I would say that, so you know you're not getting any fake China items that are trying to kind of infiltrate the search of Fear of God Essentials. From there, filter down to your size and then just go through, find an item where you are comfortable with the price. So normally it's about $100 for the sweatshirt or just the sweatpants. Some people will sell right around there. Maybe they got theirs at a discount. They don't need a good markup or need to make a big profit back. Some will certainly be above that. And if you don't want to pay that, then don't pay that. But I like to add them to a watch list, and I have a saved search on eBay where as new items pop up in my size for the filters I have for Fear of God Essentials, I can take a look and see if it's something I want to pull the trigger on. I still want sweatpants. I do. No shame, guys. Listen, I want the gray sweatpants. So I still want the sweats. I don't have those yet. I do have, again, some items on my watch list for a long sleeve shirt. I think shorts, not necessarily sweatpants yet, but shorts. And so I took the money that was left over from the vet visit because I had literally an extra $100 and a little bit of change left over because her vet visit was not as expensive as I thought it would be. And I allocated that towards picking up the Fear of God hoodie. It is very, very, very soft. I love it. Not disappointed at all. I'm glad I was able to pick this item up to add it to my closet. Now, you may say, why are you buying a hoodie in spring? Listen, it was just snowing the other day for a lot of you, and you were all freaked out and shocked. It was just snowing the other day, so I feel like this is a great pickup for myself. I will wear this on a ton of occasions, so just be aware. You guys already see, I packed it. It is an essential piece, okay? If you're gonna go out somewhere, you got your soul from his backpack, I got my essential hoodie, I'm good to go. You got your phone, you got your kicks, you don't need a whole lot more. Maybe food, water, okay? But yeah, we get that. But you got your bag, you got your hoodie, got the essentials covered, got your kicks, and you are ready to travel wherever it is you choose to travel, even if it's in the city, out of the state, doesn't matter. But please comment below, do you guys like the Fear of God Essentials line? Do you own any pieces? I converse back and forth with a few sneakerhead friends, and when we find those deals or we pick something up, we're excited, we tell each other, and that's what it's all about. Find some common interest that you have, and once you find a deal, capitalize on it, pick it up, enjoy it, have it in your collection. So thank you so much for viewing this video. As always, act your age, not your shoe size. Peace out.